Yeah, tough week. There's no doubt about it. You know, you work a lot of hours on preparation and on teams. You know, fans and a lot of people out there, they come to the games. You know, they watch the games. They don't know all the amount of time that the players spend on studying their opponent and practicing on their opponent. So that's the tough part of coaching, you know, whether it's college football, college basketball, NBA, whatever it is, whatever sport, coaches and players spend a lot of time preparing for games. And when you don't play well, when you care and you put a lot of time into it, it is very, very disappointing. You know, I was at an event yesterday that was just tremendous out at the Lake Club, Breakfast with Santa, with my two girls, and Ed Moransky does a heck of a thing for these kids and was out there. And I can't tell you, Dana, how many people said, man, Coach, you're just so close. You know, you're young, you're fun to watch, you're so close. And that's the frustrating part, is they're right on a lot of fronts. But we just got to get over that hump. We've got to do some things better. And that's why I said what I said after the game. I got to do a better job of getting our guys, you know, playing better. I think that's an important role of a coach, is get an identity, and let's start playing better consistently.
The last in this four-game slide, I think you're giving up about close to 90 and only averaging 74 or whatever.
Yep. Yeah, you know, what's crazy, Dana, is on Tuesday against Central Michigan, we only gave up 68 in regulation. And then you played the other 15 minutes, and I think you ended up giving up 100. So that score there was a little bit different. But to give up 88 against Western, that was a little disappointing. I thought our effort on Tuesday was tremendous. But you're not going to beat a lot of teams on any court in the 80s, you know. So we've got to probably six, seven, maybe eight possessions got to get better a game, Dana. And I think that'll start with our defense. But then you also have had games where your youth has shown and you've given them the ball quite a bit. You know, on Tuesday, they had 28 points off our 22 turnovers. So it's a combination of not only bad defense, I think you're onto something there, but it's also our turnovers. You know, those two kind of work hand in hand. When you give it to them, those are hard to defend. And then also shot selection. When you take bad shots, you know, Coach Huggins used to have a saying, I forget what he called it, but it's basically you're giving them a great opportunity to get a full steam ahead with a bad shot. And when you have a lot of guys playing and you give them a lot of freedom, I think at certain times, I don't know if it's a good shot or a bad shot. So we've got to do a better job explaining that. We got to do a better job controlling the game, whether that's through more sets, playing a little bit slower at times, because we're not fully there physically and mentally to play 100 miles an hour the way I want to play. So we'll work on that here the next 4 or 5 days heading into Binghamton. Yeah, we got a couple guys, Brian, that are really struggling from three. Others are shooting it really well. Kendall Hampton's been a real big boost off the bench. I think he's shooting almost 42%. But almost half of our shots are three-pointers. That's got to change. You know, you brought up a great point after the game, and you're bringing it up again. And I'm glad you are, because we practice here tonight, and that's got to be addressed. So if you want to get out of reporting and come help us out, you're right. What you said was right after the game. You know, you're very reliant on 3-point shooting. You got to shoot them. You can't have a leash on everybody if you want to play free flowing and shoot threes. But also, when you're not winning, you got to know time and score, and you got to get a better shot. When we went on that spell Saturday against Western Michigan, most of those shots, again, were pretty open shots. I watched the tape. We didn't score for, I think, almost 6 minutes, and a lot of them were wide open, whether it was layups, whether it was offensive rebounds. But, you know, I thought Garrett Covington had a tremendous week. I think he averaged 20-9. I think Naz Behandin averaged 15 rebounds and almost 6 assists. So you see the growth in certain guys, but we got to get everybody playing at the right time in the game. You know, we beat Niagara. This is what I do in my time. It was late last night, and we hadn't played Niagara in over 2 months. I think we played them in, what, October? And I went back and watched the game. And that's a team that beat Pitt at Pitt. They beat Wyoming at Wyoming. We beat that team by 20-plus. And we had five guys in double figures. So I just went back to watch the game to see what we did to be successful. And, Brian, we shot – half of our shots were threes. So it was – you know, when you asked me that question on Saturday, I wanted to go back and look at it. I think we are going to be a three-point shooting team. There's no doubt about it. But we've got to do a better job executing and taking a better shot. I will probably say no, but I think also you don't want your guys thinking a ton when you're so young. You know, I want to shoot them early or shoot them late. I don't want to shoot them in between. I think if you look at our shots when we lost, you know, we lost Fordham, very close game, possession game, Central Michigan possession game, FIU possession game. Saturday ended up being more, but really the game was lost in a few possessions. Sometimes we don't know when to shoot them and when to drive it.
How do you approach this week with finals and one game on the road?
Yeah, Dane, it's always a crazy week for all the coaches out there because, you know, first and foremost, these guys are student athletes. And a lot of them have a lot of tests and a lot of things that they've got to take care of in the classroom. So tonight we're practicing at 8 o'clock at night. You know, we wanted off yesterday. We wanted all day today to concentrate and, you know, really make sure that we're finishing this semester strong because they miss so much school the next semester. You know, our first 7 out of 9 in league play are on the road. But I also think it's a time you're a third of the way done. Once this week is over, you get a lot of basketball time. They will get 3 or 4 days off for Christmas. But I think this time of year is a time that you can get better if you're fully committed to getting better. And what I mean by that is there's no class after this week. So kids are full-time basketball. We're going to do some things out in the community. We're working with United Way. Our kids are going to go Christmas shopping and buy some toys for the kids. We're going to go visit the hospital. We're going to feed the homeless. You know, I think this time of year, you know, we have a lot to be grateful for. You know, we're not particularly happy, Dana, of our 3-8 record, but you know, there's a lot of fans. There's a lot of people here in Youngstown that I think our kids can have an impact on this community. And we're going to make sure next week when we have a couple off days before they leave town. That we get out in this community and do that. You know, that's been the biggest thing that I've learned, you know, at YSU is there's so many great coaches up here that give back to the community. And that's what we're trying to do, you know, right after that Ohio State game on Tuesday. So we'll play Saturday, we'll play Tuesday, and then we'll have 3 practices. We'll practice Wednesday, Thursday, early Friday, and then they'll get out of here for a few days. Yeah. You know, Chris Holtman, everywhere he's been, any basketball team that he's been a part of has really been a huge success. So, you know, I think it's really good for our guys to play a top 10, top 15 team in the country. You know, we got a chance to see that against Pitt in West Virginia. Now we'll get to see it a third time right before league play. It obviously helps pay a lot of bills. You know, that's really, really important. But I have such, you know, admiration for what Chris has done at Ohio State. That's not easy following a legend in Thad Matta. You know, Thad's a legend and a guy that I've spent a lot of time with over the years and picked his brain last year. So it'll be a good opportunity. It'll be a huge challenge. They're playing really, really well. But it'll be great right before the conference approaches.
Yeah.
Yeah, you know, it depends what happens this week. But right now, Dane, if you look at the Horizon League standings, there's three teams that have winning records. I think scheduling it at our level is extremely difficult. It's harder than anything you do. It's harder than coaching your team. It's harder than recruiting. It's very, very difficult, to be honest with you. So we've played, I think, the 154th best schedule in the country. We've played a pretty tough schedule. You know, you only had two home games against Division I opponents with Central and Western. But you had a lot of good opportunities. I thought New York was really good for us. You know, going at Robert Morris, playing Akron neutral. You know, we've had some good opportunities to play some like opponents. Then you also have your three bye games. I think what you got to do, Dane, is you look at your full body of work, and then you try to make some adjustments. As I said, there's no class. You try to work on certain things that you can get better at. You certainly got to get your guys' confidence level where it needs to be to compete and get better. But as you know, this league is wild. Horizon League is much better this year than it was last year. Just, you know, statistically, I think right now we're 21 or 22 best conference in the country. Last year we were 28, 29. So there's some good teams. There's really, really good teams at the top. But I think where it's gotten better is the second tier has really gotten good. So we'll open up with two home games, and then, boom, you're on the road out of Youngstown for a long period of time. So we got to enjoy our time while we're home and get to sleep in our own beds. Yeah, you know, most freshmen really, really struggle with effort. The adjustment from high school to college, the effort on a daily basis, I would say in every sport, is really, really hard to handle. With him, that has not been the case. He played for his dad, played at Huber Heights Wayne, a very, very good program. Where he's had a hard time adjusting is sequences where the game needs to slow down a little bit. Darius is a guy that wants to go and play up and down, and that's why we recruited him. But we're not fully there yet to pressing and playing up and down for 40. So in his defense, it's not totally his fault that he hasn't played outstanding, but he's a freshman. We're excited about him. I think he's going to get better and better. I think by league play, you're going to see his numbers get better. He's going to get to the free throw line more. He'll shoot the ball better. His assist to turnover will go up. All those things will get better. I think not only with Darius, but I think all our freshmen, they got 11 games under their belt. They're going to end up playing three high major teams. You can only get better, and I think that's the exciting part about this group. Yeah, you know, watch the tape and try to figure out why we're not shooting a good percentage. Is it the shot selection? Is it the pass? Is it time and score? You know, there's a lot that goes into it, Brian, a lot of film study, a lot of on-court stuff. But, you know, part of it is these kids haven't really been playing together a whole very long at all. 11 games sounds like a lot, but in the grand scheme of things, it's really not. Not when most of these guys have been playing high school or junior college basketball. Even our returning guys don't have a lot of experience. You know, Nas and Garrett have played in big venues. They've played in every Horizon League gym, but, you know, they're only in year two. They haven't even competed in their second year of the league. So we're very, very young in a lot of areas.